Welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. Dear students, I am very happy to meet you again. In this video, we are going to discuss a new topic, sense organ. In sense organs, eye, ear, nose, skin, all these things are there. Today we are going to see about the ear. Ear is the hearing organ. This ear performs two functions. One is hearing. We know very well about it, hearing. The second one is body balancing. It is called equilibrium of body. So these two functions performs by the ear, but in the ear various structures are there. So each structure performs various function. For example, ear has three regions. Ear has three regions. One is external ear. This is visible to eye. This is external ear. So second region is middle ear. Third region is inner ear. So what is the role of external ear? What is the role of middle ear? What is the role of inner ear? What are the structures present in external, middle and inner ear? So these are the things we are going to discuss now. So first we see that here a diagram is there. This is a structure of human ear. So I already told that human ear has three regions. One, external ear. Second one, middle ear. Third, internal ear. So out of three regions, so which is external ear, which is middle ear, which is internal ear? Now we are going to see the detail. So this outer structure, we know that this red color part, this is called pinna. It's called what? Pinna. Pinna otherwise called auricle. This pinna is made up of auricular muscles. It is immovable. And one more interesting information for you students, the presence of pinna is a characteristics of mammals. No other class groups has pinna. If you have pinna, means you are definitely you are mammals. So you know that mammalian characters, presence of pinna, presence of hair, presence of mammary gland. These are the three important characteristics of mammals, which does not have other groups of animals. So pinna is the comes under external ear. So from pinna we know that there is a canal. So this is a canal. A tube is there. This tube is called auditory meatus. Auditory meatus. This is a small canal is there. So next to auditory meatus, there is one more structure. See this, the black structure. This structure is called tympanic membrane or ear drum. It is called what? Ear drum. So pinna, from pinna a tube is there. That is called auditory meatus. And very next to tube, there is a small structure is there, a membrane is there. That is called tympanic membrane or ear drum. Simply you can say TM. Simply you can say TM, tympanic membrane. So these three parts, one pinna, auditory meatus, tympanic membrane, comes under external ear. Comes under external ear. So next to this cavity is there. This is a air-filled cavity. This is a air-filled cavity. It's called air-filled cavity. In this structure, air-filled cavity, otherwise you can say tympanic cavity. Here three small bones are there. So this, the green color one, the blue color one, and red color one. Three bones, three small bones are there. These three bones collectively called ear ossicles. What is this? Ear ossicles. So it is called ear ossicles. Ear ossicles. The first one, that is called malleus. What is called? Malleus, small bone. Very next to small bone, it is attached. Very close to, it is attached to malleus. One more bone, that is called incus. What? Incus. The third bone, there is a, this is a red part, this is called stapes. So malleus, incus, stapes. So these are the three bones, small bones. They are collectively called what? Ear ossicles. These three bones are present in the middle cavity, middle ear, in the tympanic cavity, ear-filled cavity. So now this stapes is one more information, significant important structure is there. This stapes is the smallest bone of the body. This is the very smallest bone. We know that longest bone humor. But here what happens? The smallest bone is stapes, which is present in the middle ear. So this stape attached to incus. Incus attached to malleus. They are close to each other. They are like this. There is no gap at all. There is close to each other. So suppose imagine that this is malleus. This is incus, and here stapes. So three bones are attached each other. So these three bones are present in the middle ear. This cavity is called tympanic cavity or air filled cavity is there. From this cavity, one tube is there. So this, see this tube. It goes to pharynx. It goes to pharynx. This is called Eustachian canal or tube. Eustachian canal or Eustachian tube, we can say. This goes to pharynx. What is the use of this tube? It releases the excess air to the pharynx. So far we have seen, ear has three regions. One is external ear, one is middle ear, and third one is inner ear. In external ear, pinna is present, pinna is made, otherwise called auricles, otherwise it is made up of auricular muscles. It is immovable. It is a characteristics of mammal. So this continues to a tube. A canal is there, that is called artery meatus. This is called what? Artery meatus. Otherwise you can say artery meatus, okay. Artery canal. So in the end of artery canal, there is a structure, there is a membrane, is a black color structure. It's called what? Tympanic membrane, as it's called eardrum. This comes under external ear. In the middle ear, there is a tympanic cavity is there, air-filled cavity. Three small bones are there, malleus, incus, stapes. This malleus, incus, stapes, we can easily remember by a code word like this, miss. You know miss, my miss, like that. So miss means M, malleus, I, incus, S, stapes. This malleus is hammer shape. What is the shape? Hammer. Whereas the incus has anvil shape. Anvil shape. Whereas stapes, a stirrup shape. So you can say miss has, like this, miss has, a code word. Easy to remember. What is miss has? Malleus, incus, stapes. Malleus, hammer shape. Incus, anvil shape. Stapes, stirrup bone. So miss has, it's a code word. Easy to remember. What are the three bones present in the middle cavity or middle ear? That is called ear ossicles. So next we are seeing third part. This is second part. Second middle ear. This is first one. External ear, middle ear, inner ear. So inner ear is most significant, more complex also, because in this region we have one more structure, the green color structure, coil like structure. This is called cochlea. It's called what? Cochlea. This cochlea opens, connect with the stapes. Connect with the stapes. This round is called round window. It's called what? Round window. The first one is called oval window. This middle ear, the last part is stapes, smallest bone of the body. This stapes opens in cochlea, a coil like structure, a snail like structure, with the opening of two openings. One is called oval window, the upper part. The second one is called a round window. So through this, the cochlea is open. So apart from this, there is a canals are there. These canals are called semi-circular canals. What is this? Semi-circular canals. So 1, 2, 3. So anterior in position, posterior in position, lateral in position. So three semicircular canals are there. And these two structure comes under inner ear. This is called what? Inner ear. So before that, these structures covered by a bony labyrinth. Bony labyrinth. So this is outer portion. This is called bony labyrinth. So this portion. Like this. The green color part. The outer green one is, blue one is called bony labyrinth. It's called what? Bony labyrinth. The green color part is called membranous labyrinth. Membranous labyrinth. So in this canal, a fluid is there. It's called perilymph and endolymph. We will discuss later what is perilymph, what is endolymph. This nerve which arises from the cochlea, that is called vestibuli cochlear nerve. Vestibuli cochlear nerve. So the third part is called inner ear. This inner ear has three structures. One is called labyrinth. Second one is called cochlea. Third part is called vestibules. So here the simple structure of ear. Once again, I want a simple explanation for you. Ear performs two functions. One is hearing and one is body balancing. It has three regions. One is external ear, middle ear, internal ear. External ear contains pinna, artery meatus, tympanic membrane. Second, middle ear contains ear ossicles, that is called malleus, incus, stapes. So these three bones collectively called ear ossicles, they are attached to each other. Attached to each other. What is the shape of the malleus? Hammer shape. What is the shape of the incus? Anvil shape. What is the shape of the stapes? Stirrup bone shape. So like that, a code word is here, we can understand easily memory this three ossicles. So you simply say miss this sequence. First one is M, second one is I, third one is S. So here M, I, S. Miss we can say. So this is the sequence, which is first one, very close to tympanic membrane, malleus. Very near to, very close to malleus, incus. Next to incus, stapes. This stape separate the inner ear and middle ear. So between the inner ear and the middle ear, there is a bone that is called stapes. One more significant character is, it is the smallest bone of the body. Now, we will see the regions of ear. I have already explained the regions. Once again, I want to explain in a simple manner. So how many regions are there? Actually, three regions. Three regions are there. One, two, three regions are there. The first region is external ear. The first one is external ear. The second one is middle ear. The third one inner ear. So what are the organs present in external ear? I already told, the first one is pinna or auricle. The pinna is made up of auricular muscle, made up of auricular muscles. This pinna, it is a mammalian characters. This pinna, what is the function actually? It is immovable. What is the function? It collects the sound waves, that's all. It is the only function. It collects the sound waves. These sound waves are focused into eustachian tube. So this is the only function for the pinna. It collects the sound waves. The second structure is auditory meatus or auditory canal. Canal is there. So here I have drawn already. So this is pinna. So this is called what? Auditory meatus. So pinna, auditory meatus, second part, second region. This auditory meatus, what is the role actually? This auditory meatus has a gland that is called ceruminous gland. What? Ceruminous gland. This gland secretes a secretion that is called wax. So what? A wax like substance. This wax like substance, it is an immune system. It is an immune power. It has immune power. It prevents the entry of microbes. Especially in the region, this region, this is auditory meatus. This is small hairs are there. So this hairs and also wax. This is hairs. So in the auditory meatus, wax also present, hairs, small hairs are present. Hair. These together filter the air and so that it prevents the entry of microbes. So it gives immune system. The third region of external ear is called tympanic membrane or ear drum. Ear drum. So this tympanic membrane, see this, here one membrane is there, like this. This is called what? Tympanic membrane, eardrum, you can see. So these three regions comes under external ear. So what is the middle ear? This middle ear has a tympanic cavity. Tympanic cavity. So in this tympanic cavity, what is present? Ear ossicles are there. Ear ossicles. What are three ossicles? Malleus, incus, stapes. Three small bones are there. These three bones are attached with each other. Attached with each other. So like this. So this is malleus, this is incus, this is stapes, like this. So malleus, incurs steps. So we can say shortly miss. So here M I S, we can remember easily. This is called what? Miss. This malleus is hammer shape, so H. This incus is anvil shape. This step is stirrup shape, stirrup bone shape. So you can see stirrup bone shape. So you can see simply yes. So shortly you can remember what are the three ossicles: malleus, incus, steps. You can say miss has. It's a easy trick to memory. What are the three bones of three ear ossicles? Malleus, incus, steps. Malleus attached to incus, incus attached to steps. So malleus attached to tympanic membrane. So here one side I want to draw. So this is pinna, artery meatus. In this artery meatus, a structure is as ever tympanic membrane. So pinna, artery meatus, TM. That is called tympanic membrane. These three structures comes under external ear. So this structure, malleus, incus, steps, this structure comes under middle ear. And one more structure, that is called Eustachian tube, which opens in pharynx. It is a connection between pharynx and nose. So from nose, there is a connection to the pharynx. So this is called Eustachian tube. These three structures comes under middle ear. Then what about the inner ear? This inner ear has labyrinth. This labyrinth has two types. One is membranous labyrinth, two, bony labyrinth. Again, this labyrinth has two structures. One is vestibules. One is called vestibules. One is semicircular canals. So labyrinth, semicircular canals, and one more structure that is called cochlea. So these are the structures present in the inner ear. What is vestibule? What is semicircular canal? What is cochlea? What are the functions? What is the significant role of semicircular canals and vestibules? Especially cochlea performs hearing function. Whereas these two, vestibules, and it performs body balance or equilibrium functions. So what is the mechanism of hearing? How the cochlea function? What are the special structures present in the cochlea? These are the things we're going to discuss in next video. So here I want to say regions of ear: external ear, middle ear, and inner ear. So I draw here. So this is three semicircular canals. So here vestibules like this. So this is cochlea, vestibule, this is semicircular canals. So I think it is easy to understand, easy to memory. So external ear, what are the structures present? These are three structures. What is the structure of middle ear? These are the three things: ear ossicles, and Eustachian tube, and a tympanic cavity. So what is the inner ear? It has a labyrinth structure. The second one is a vestibule, a semicircular canal, and a cochlea. So this is the important features of ear. Thank you.